Shalom, and welcome back to Wife Hack by Tina Cherie. So this title I'm going to be doing or talking about today is gonna be, you need some work. Is that how they say it? You need some work. Because we need work. Oh my goodness, we need work. So I need you guys to take your Bibles out and turn with me to Romans 12, 2. It's going to be in the NIV. Yeah, you know me. Okay. So it says, do not conform to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewing of your mind. Then you will be able to test and approve what God's will is and his good, pleasing, and perfect will. Father God, we just praise you and we thank you, God. We give you all the glory. Give you all the honor. Thank you, Father God. We love you. And God, right now we ask that you forgive us sins so that way that our prayers are not hindered. Right now we are asking for clarity. Let us get the understanding that you want to get to through us. And I thank you, Father God, for that in the name of Yeshua. Amen. Okay. So when I thought about this, I kept hearing that song by In Vogue. I think it's In Vogue. I'm not trying to date myself or nothing, but it's In Vogue. But it's the song that kept replaying in my head was Free Your Mind and the Rest Will Follow. Do you remember that? Free your mind and the rest will follow. Okay. So that was the song that was like kind of playing back and forth in my mind. And what that was like signifying to me, we have to get our mind right. We have to get our mind right. We have to get our mind right. So we can be the person that God needs us to be. So we can be healed of whatever needs to be healed. So when we're in the relationship that God has ordained for us to be in, our minds is right. We ain't cray cray up in here, let me tell you. So I asked God, like, okay, so what would be, like, how is this relevant? And he said to me, so a lot of the things that we're holding on to are childhood traumas. We don't put the notebook down because we about to get into this. Oh, okay. A lot of the stuff that we as adults now are dealing with is childhood trauma. Example. So imagine you're a little girl. You're like 5, 6, whatever. And your dad, your father, he goes and he's like, oh, I'm gonna go down to the store and go get some milk. That's where that, anyway, I'm gonna go get some milk and then I'll be right back. But then he like never comes back and he's just gone. So now you went from a two-parent household to a a one person household. And so then you, after some time has expired and went by, he reaches back out to you. So you're like, okay, but I want to see you. So then he's like, okay, I'll be there on Friday when you're done with school. So you're like, okay, but you never asked me questions because that's that childlike faith. You said it, so I believe it. Another word. So Friday comes after school, you get home and you're like, yes, all happy and you're all ready. And you're just like, oh my God, my dad's coming. And so you're waiting by the window so you can see him in the parking lot pull up. And you're waiting and waiting. You're waiting. And so you fall asleep by the window, still waiting. You ain't even eat no dinner. Still waiting. And your mom wakes you up and like, let's just go. That's the night of the first trauma. Hopefully it was your first trauma. But that's the night where you learned abandonment and you learned how it feels when somebody tells you they're going to do something and they don't do it. It's the first betrayal. It's the first heartache. So, with that being said, we need to get our minds renewed. We need to be focused on him. We have to ask him to heal us of whatever those old wounds are, so that way we can walk into our God-ordained purpose and be in a relationship with our God-ordained spouse. If we don't, then fast forward. You ain't never got healed. You never tried to renew your mind. But let me tell you, you probably wasn't even in church. What? You probably wasn't in church. So you ain't even thinking about nothing like that. And it's totally okay. There's time. Oh, there is a time for you. Let me tell you. But fast forward, you are 25 now. So it's been 20 years. It's been 20 years. You're 25. And let's say you and your boyfriend get into a huge argument. You get into a huge argument. And then he, because let me tell you this, there's nothing wrong with this either. If you're doing it the right way, if you're doing it to be manipulative, problem. But if you're doing it because this is just the way that God has designed you, let's say he's healthy. Let's say he got his stuff together. Let's say it. But you guys get in an argument. He's like, you know what? I can't. I have to go. I have to clear my mind. Because let me tell you, sometimes that's how people are. We have to go clear our mind. We got to get in God's presence. Be like, God, was I in a wrong? Oh my God. But that's just what it is. So then it's like, okay, I just want to clear my mind. Let me go. And then she snaps because she remembers that same heartache and that same pain. He said he's going to go clear his mind. Oh, maybe he's going to go do something else. Because I'm used to men telling me. Oh, I'm used to men telling me something and then doing something completely different. I'm used to men disappointing me and betraying me and not following through on what they said. Their follow through is just par, right? So then she's like blocking the door. And then he's getting frustrated. And then she's like, no, you're not leaving. And he's like, but I need to. I need to clear my mind. Like, sometimes some people got little things they trying to work through. And they ain't trying to become the Hulk. Oh, my God, they're not trying to become Hulk. But you're blocking. You're blocking. You're blocking. You're blocking. So it escalates. Oh, it escalates. It escalates. And it could become physical because you have abandonment issues. You think he's going to walk out on you. And it was like, no, literally, he's a good dude. He needed to go pray. Oh, he needed to go pray. He needed to go clear his mind so he can come at you out of love to tell you, this is why I think it's right. But if he's praying, God could convict him as well. But because you have those issues, you made it something. Now y'all got to deal with going to prison or jail. I shouldn't know about all this, but I do. Now you got to deal with court and fees, and your kids get taken out of the house because they're like, oh, it's unsafe because y'all boxing. This is not a Floyd Mayweather fight. But either which way, if you don't deal with those issues, if you don't put God first, seek ye first the kingdom of God, if you don't do that, then you're going to carry that into that relationship. And it could have been a blessing to you, but you jacked it up. Get your mind right. Get your mind right. Even if you don't believe what I believe, get your mind right. Get your mind right. Get your mind right. Father, we just come before you. We ask you to help us become clearer in our thoughts and clear in our hearts and our intentions. God, we just pray that you give us a renewing of our minds so we can think more like you and be who you've called us to be. We thank you for that in the name of Jesus. Amen. I'm going to pivot. Oh, I like to do my pivots. Y'all know this. I'm going to pivot back. Watch Bishop Kevin Foreman and Harvest Church. Today is actually Martin Luther King Day. So he said to watch American Idols in honor of today. Or you can watch The Roots. If you are an overachiever like I am, oh, watch them both. But watch those series. It will bless you. And I think, or I hope this, like, blessed you. If somebody would have told me those same things were affecting me as an adult, oh, it would be different. But I hope it blessed you. I will see you soon. And get your mind right. Have a good day. Bye.